Hi all, it is Faith. I'm doing another video. I just wanted to come out and say hello to everyone. I think it's been a couple of months since I did my last video. It has officially been 1 year since my surgery, which was the anniversary of it was last week, but I was getting my hair done this week, so I thought I'd wait. As you can tell, maybe this is something that should be a separate video compilation of my videos that would show all of the different hairdos and different hair colors that I've had throughout the couple of years that I've been putting these videos together. I like to change my hair, what can I say? Anyway, so hi, and hope everybody's doing well. I wanted to give an update on what's going on with my face. Not much has changed since the last video. Because that last video was showing, I think it's been two videos now that I've been showing that my hemifacial spasm, which is what these videos are about, has pretty much stopped. I have a hemifacial spasm on the left side of my face, and so I'm pretty much at this point just going ahead and following up to show the changes since my surgery. I had the microvascular decompression surgery in April of 2018. It is currently the first week of May of 2019. So like I said, it's been a full year now since I had the surgery. It took approximately 5 months for my spasms to begin to significantly diminish. They were somewhat diminished immediately after the surgery, but not by a lot. They were still pretty prevalent, and it took a few months for them to finally kind of settle down. At this point in time, I do still have little fluttering that happens every now and then, almost like how things were in the very beginning onset of my hemifacial spasm when I started experiencing it about 13, 14 years ago. It does happen from time to time. Sometimes it happens on both sides of my face. It happens to the right eye as well. It does stick to the eye more than anything else, which again is where the hemifacial spasm tends to begin and start for most people, I think. And I'm not going to lie, those moments freak me out a lot, but I try not to dwell on them. I try to focus on how awesome it is that they aren't as bad as they used to be. Another thing that I'm always trying to document with these videos and make sure about is I did Botox for an extended period, not an extended period. I think a lot of people have done Botox for, you know, more power to them, but far too long before they actually consider doing surgery. I think in whether it's a fear of getting the surgery done or if they've been told that they can't get the surgery done for some reason or another, if there's a cost involved, I'm not sure, you know, why people prefer to do the Botox for extended periods. I had Botox for, I think, a little bit less than 2 years before I decided to go ahead and move on to get the surgery done. And I think there were extended effects from that Botox. I stopped having it injected probably 6 months before my surgery, a full six, maybe even 7 months before my surgery. And for a long time after, I could still, there was a latency to the movement on the left side of my face. And also I'm just going to stop here real quick and make sure that I mention, I know the quality of this video is kind of crappy. It's my computer. Sometimes I'm just lazy. I don't want to set up the tripod for my phone to do the video. And I don't know where my tripod is actually at this point in time. So you're getting computer video this time. Anyway, so if it's kind of choppy and bleh, hopefully you're still getting the gist of how things are going. But let's see, I think you can see pretty well what's going on with my face, and how things are going, but I just want to tuck my hair back so you can get a better idea, of how the movement is, how even things have gotten, how things have kind of come back together, as it were. I don't know if my nostrils are still, it seemed like for a while my nostrils were, one was different from the other, my eyes are all moving. Everything seems good. So my smile is good. So maybe we'll turn these videos into a discussion of Game of Thrones. If anybody's into that, we're in the final season right now and I'm into it, having a fun time. Although I have to say, I like watching the Trey Crowder recaps of Game of Thrones, and I don't think anybody needs anything beyond Trey Crowder when it comes to Game of Thrones recaps and discussions. If you haven't watched them, I'm going to go ahead and put his name in the information on this, maybe in a top comment on this. You have to go check them out. If you're a Game of Thrones watcher and you enjoy some good comedy, you should be checking that out. Anyway, total sidebar, but I don't know what else, you know, to talk about. If anybody has any questions, if y'all have any questions or concerns or, you know, sometimes there's some snarky comments that I've been getting lately. I handle those as well. I am snarky myself. Feel free to put them into my, well, I can be snarky. Don't push me. Go ahead and put them into the comment section and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. I hope everybody's doing well. I know this, again, as I always like to say and close out with, this is a crappy condition that none of us asked for, and none of us deserve it, I am sure. Maybe a couple of people do, but anyway, I say keep on keeping on. Get out there and make sure you keep living your life. If people are looking at your face weird or ask you why your face moves, tell them. Let them know what's going on. I think the more people who know about this condition, the better. So, you know, let's use it as opportunities to educate people and try not to let it control us and keep us in our basements and keep us from being able to get out and being social and living life, all right? I hope you're all doing well. And I will talk to you again soon, I think. All right? We'll see what my hair does next time. Bye, everyone.